back, Mr. Gorman.
I'm Sarah Brock.
And I'm Haley Hayhurst.
And we hope that you had a memorable winter break.
It's a new semester, which means new grades, new friends, and new goals. Please stand for the prayer and the pledge. Let us remember that we're in God's holy presence.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.
Thank you, Lord, for giving me the brand new year ahead. Help me live the way I should as each new day I tread. Give me gentle wisdom that I might help a friend. Give me strength and courage so a shoulder I might lend. The year ahead is empty. Help me fill it with good things. Each new day filled with joy and happiness it brings.
Glory be to God in all things. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.
Now for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Are you ready to have the best semester ever, Bishop Gorman? Because BGTV is coming at you in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Rocking the fight song, screaming for freshmen, climbing up the old G tower, jumping a jacuzzi made out of cement, giving a dead cat a shower. Start every class with prayer, cartwheels don't mess his hair, rocking out with teachers who dance. Always it go one way, iPads are here to stay, trying to look good in those pants. This could possibly be the best day ever.
This could possibly be the best day ever.
And the forecast says that tomorrow will likely be 1,000,006 times better. So make every minute count, jump up, jump in, and seize the day. And let's make sure that in every single possible way, today is gonna be a great day.
Good morning, Bishop Gorman.
I'm Carlyn McCormick.
And I'm Kelton Sorenson.
And this is BGTV.
It's Friday, January 9th, 2015, and unfortunately, this is not the best day ever in France, where breaking at this moment, the two suspected radical Islamic terrorists who brutally massacred 12 people in the office of a newspaper Wednesday morning are dead. In an area north of Paris, police located the two alleged gunmen who shouted Allahu Akbar and the Prophet has been avenged as they gunned down journalists, police officers, and a maintenance person Wednesday morning. This video is chilling. Those suspects took a hostage and were surrounded by police and military personnel in a printing house about 25 miles outside of Paris. Minutes ago, police, gunfire, and explosions were heard from that printing plant as the police apparently moved in. Once again, it is confirmed that the two suspected Islamic terrorists from Wednesday's massacre in Paris are dead.
In a separate but related incident, two other terrorists have taken five hostages into a kosher supermarket in Paris. They threatened to kill their hostages if police move in on the two other jihadists from Wednesday's massacre. Unconfirmed reports say those hostages include women and children. And just a few minutes ago, gunfire and explosions have been heard at that location. It is now confirmed that the second set of terrorists have been killed and the hostages are alive. So if there's any good news this morning at all, is that the suspected terrorists are dead.
Please keep everyone involved in your prayers today, and remember to pray for an end to all the senseless killing of innocents by terrorists in the name of their religion.
New year, new me is the mantra heard seemingly every January around the new year. I went around our campus to see how prevalent New Year's resolutions are to our Bishop Gorman staff.
As the new year rolls around, people look toward the future with hope and undaunted ambition. Millions create their resolutions, but less than 10% are actually successful.
These positive changes can be physical, emotional, mental, or even financial.
I am going to cut back on my Starbucks first and foremost.
and then probably stay away from the outlet malls.
My New Year's resolution is to exercise more this semester. I plan to talk to Mr. DeMaria, come out with the baseball team and throw the ball around a little bit. I want to talk to Mr. Cooley and make sure it's okay if I can go out to the track, do some laps, sit-ups, and push-ups.
But as the year progresses, the success rate begins to plummet.
My New Year's resolution was to cook more. So far, so good, but today's my first day back to work, so I don't know if it's going to last past today.
Up to this point, I haven't done anything yet, but this is the week I start.
A majority of them do not succeed for multiple reasons.
People set goals on a whim. They don't think about what their New Year's resolution is going to be, and they make it up at the last seconds before midnight.
As in many things, preparation and attitude are key to success.
Set your goals reasonably. Make small steps. Make sure you're encouraging others to do their goals and having others encourage you. Reward yourself for the small goals that you take, as well as being mindful of setbacks, making sure that when you do mess up or you do go back on your New Year's resolution, that you keep on towards a successful goal, even though there was a minor setback.
Successful or not, New Year's resolutions continue to challenge and develop individuals on their journey throughout life. I'm Kelton Sorenson, reporting for BGTV.
On this day in 2007, Steve Jobs announced the launch of the first ever iPhone. While I might not be changing the face of consumer electronics with these announcements, they are still pretty relevant, so you might want to listen up. Congratulations to our two freshmen of the week, Hannah Lee and Mary Nicholson. Keep up the great work. The jewelry club that is led by Cassandra Tate sold their handmade jewelry and donated 100% of the money to the Sage Tree Women's Shelter during winter break. Thanks for your hard work, guys.
2014 brought us Sharknado 2, Kimye, and Happy in Man Buns. While we're all definitely ready to leave that and let that all go, let us take a quick recap at some of the hits and misses with 2014.
Kayla Schifrin becomes the youngest ever Olympic slalom champion.
Jamie Anderson guaranteed herself an Olympic medal.
Thousands of Russian forces occupy the Crimean Peninsula.
The Seattle Seahawks did that tonight.
Beauty, romance, love. These are what we stay alive for.
We stop defining each other by what we are not and start defining ourselves by who we are. We can all be freer.
For the third time, we're getting a final between the Germans and the Argentinians.
Have you guys heard of the Ice Bucket Challenge?
I needed to raise my voice because I wanted to go back to school. But at the time when no one speaks, your voice gets so louder that everyone has to listen to it.
Love liberates. It doesn't just hold. Love liberates.
It's an amazing and really powerful thing to be celebrated for who you are. I want to spend my life making them feel seen and heard.
Derek Jeter ends his final game with a walk-off single.
Let's turn over the show to Dylan Bruton, who has the latest three-pointers on our Bishop Gorman basketball team. Dylan?
Thank you, Carlyn. Let's get to these sports real quick. Our Bishop Gorman men's basketball team has been killing it on the court, like such as when they only lost one game in the Tarkanian tournament and then went undefeated in the beach ball tournament. Last night they took on our rival, Palo Verde. Let's go to the video. Zimmerman gives the ball to JP. JP can't find anywhere to go. It looks like Palo's been playing pretty good zone defense. JP kicks it to Zach. Kicks it to Byron, finishes with the contested layup. The next play, Zimmerman shows off some serious handles. Ugo passes to Chase Jeter, and he dunks it down. Chase in the post, easy money. Zimmerman, ooh, a beautiful pass, all the way to Ugo, who hits the three. Richie passes it to Zim. Zim passes to Zach. Oh, and then Zim gets the dunk. Richie misses the shot, and then Chase, he's just too big. It's always nice to see Gorman come away with a W. Our women's basketball team also took on Paolo in the first game last night, and it was all about the defense. The Lady Gales only allowed 16 points all game. Good job, ladies. Also, a shout out to Coach Kenny Sanchez for being named the head coach of our varsity football team. Kenny's been a defensive coordinator at Gorman for the last 6 years. Good luck this year, Coach. Let's get ring number 7. Before I sign off, though, rest in peace to Stuart Scott. You're the best of my hero, and that's what I want to be like. That's it for sports. I'm Dylan Bruton, and you keep it chill, Bishop Gorman.
Thanks, Dylan. That's it for our first show of 2015. I'm Carlyn McCormick.
And I'm Kelton Sorenson.
And this is BGTV.